Life is a journey.
咱的人生是一个旅程。
As we go through life, we will experience fun, adventure, and blessing.
当咱经过人生这条路的时阵，咱会经历到有趣味的代志、冒险和探索这个世界。
However, in this journey, we will also face challenges and difficulties.
但是这个在人生的这条路的时阵，咱也是会同时拄到面对到真侪挑战和困难。
We will face roadblocks and detours.
咱伫会拄到路顶的一挂叫做阻碍和弯弯翘翘的路。
And we will experience misfortunes or even injuries.
而且呢，咱也是有法会经历到一挂叫做不幸的代志，和一挂伤害的代志。
But what do we do then when we face such circumstance?
所以当咱也是面对到遮挫折的时阵，咱应该着做的是啥呢？
Is there a way for us to ask for help to move forward?
是毋是咱有啥物方法通互咱搁进前行，通来叫啥来帮助咱无？
What can we do so that we will not be stuck in our situation?
咱应该着做啥物代志，则袂定定伫遐扣留伫一个所在，袂走出去？
Who can we run to?
啥我通来正做咱的帮助？
This morning, as we continue our series on the Song of Ascents, let us learn together about the message of
Psalm 121.
Three times a year, all male Jewish are required by the law of Moses to go up to Jerusalem.
按照摩西的法律的要求，一年三拜。所有犹太人的男人应该就去到耶路撒冷底下来敬拜。
They go up to Jerusalem to offer worship and sacrifice to God at the temple.
因为跩犹太人的男的应该就去到耶路撒冷，去到上个山，伫圣殿内面底下来敬拜来献祭。
And now Jerusalem is located on top of the mountain called Mount Zion.
咱也知影，耶路撒冷伊地点是伫以色列国。
And as people go up to Jerusalem, they start singing songs, and that is called the Psalm of Ascents.
So, 当遮犹太人伊徛咧往着一个小路，要往着这个山下去时阵，伫路咧就唱遮诗歌。
And that Psalm of Ascents, one of that Psalm is Psalm 121.
伫真侪诗歌所记咩，其中一首就是诗篇121篇。
So Psalm 121 begins.I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
So, 121篇头两节甲咱讲，我要往山脚目，我的帮助对倒落来的，我的帮助是对造天对的耶和华遐来的。
Jewish males travel from their home going up to Jerusalem.
咱知影犹太人的遮男人。因就离开因的家乡，然后就上行这条路，要往耶路撒冷遐去。
But this travel is not just a vacation.
但是咱知影，因要去耶路撒冷哦，对来讲，唔是去，可能要去佚佗，要去旅行。
Because they need to be ready to go and hike up the mountain.
因为应该都爱先做好准备，因为要行这条路是无容易的，因为要上山。
They will have to prepare well because the travel will be tiring.
因都爱准备好些，因为伫这个路程呢，非常的辛苦。
It will require strength and endurance.
都需要真大的力量甲耐力。
The mountain can be rocky and slippery.
而且咱知影山的路有时阵哦真侪石头的，有时阵路是真滑。
And it will can be discouraging because it's so big and imposing.
而且呢，行上山的路的时阵，看起来予咱予因真。真艰苦，行真失望，因为呢，看起来是真艰苦完成的。
At the same time, the travel can be unpredictable and dangerous.
而且呢，要行这条山的路呢，也是无法通拄到一挂叫做想袂到的发生的代志，然后也是真非常的危险。
Because the road leading up to the mountain or down from the mountain is the favorite hangout of robbers and wild animals.
因为咱知影，要上山这条路呢，真侪密伫内面的，那毋是遮大贼仔。
So imagine the situation of the travelers.
So you 想想到，遮人要去到山的顶面呢，因所经过的危险是大何等的大。
But the psalmist sing this song in terms of declaring their faith.
但是诗人呢，伊伫咧行这条要上山的路呢，就当时吟这首诗歌，伫啊来宣告伊对上帝耶和华的信心。
I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from?
伊讲，我要往山脚目，我的帮助是对倒落来的。
Similar to the travelers, we are also experiencing our own journey.
交在是交是人生宽，咱每一个人拢伫咧行一条人生的路。
I'm sure all of us are climbing our own personal mountains.
我相信咱每一个人拢有家己上家己的山。
But for most of us, that climb is already difficult and draining.
对一寡人来讲，咱咧行咱一条咱个人的一条山的路呢，是非常的艰苦。
In Tagalog, gumagapang ka na paakyat.
但是用菲律宾话来讲哦，咱哦唔是咧行，是咧爬。
Your mountains may be a difficult situation that you are struggling with currently.
你的山可能代表你现在所遇到真困难的代志。
You may be squeezed in a difficult position right now, and you have to decide within that pressure within your workplace or in your family.
你伫一个情况内面的时阵，你面对真大压力，你应该就即阵啊就做一个决定。
For some of us, it may be disappointments over our personal dreams and future goals.
对一寡人来讲， 因为山呢是代表因无法当达到完成的一个梦想甲人生的目标。
For some of us, we may face a mountain, whether our boss, our job, or perhaps a difficult marriage.
对一寡人来讲，因为山可能是因诶头家，啊是因工作，啊是因婚姻所遇到的困难，交其他的问题。
It could also be a personal problem, financial problem, or health issues.
啊是讲到伊。 这个山是代表公司一个人的问题，一健康的问题，还是经济层面的问题？
And then we ask ourselves, who can help us?
然后就问自己，我所遇到面对这些问题，谁能帮助我？
Who can help us then?
谁能帮助我？
But the psalmist is teaching us this.
但是诗人安尼教咱，
When we look up to our mountains, when we face our challenges, we can find help that comes from the Lord.
当咱面对咱的山，当咱面对咱的问题的时阵，你咱就发通讲说，咱的帮助是对耶和华来的。
The psalmist himself answered his own question.
可见咱会看到诗人家己回答家己的问题。
My help comes from the Lord.
我的帮助是对耶和华来的。
How about us?
对伊咱呢？
When we need help, who do we go to for rescue?
当咱遇到问题的时阵，咱需要帮助，咱是找向啥讨帮助呢？
During Bible times, mountains and hilltops are famous places of temple worships of false gods.
在圣经的时代呢，山及山顶哦，也是发动予咱知影，讲说是一挂叫做啊，人去达咧敬拜假神，也是敬拜假神啊，假神啊是偶像的所在。
So when people see the mountains and hilltops, they are always reminded of these false gods.
所以当一挂因遮人若看到山的顶面呢，就予因想到讲说。 假神那是拜偶像的代志。
But those Jewish people, as they traveled up to Jerusalem and look at the mountains,
但是当作犹太人的时阵，因底下行一条上山的路呢，伊看到山的时阵，
they are declaring a different God.
因底下咧宣告另外一位神。
Instead of the false God, they are declaring the true God.
因唔是底下咧宣告假神，因是咧宣告真神。
They are declaring that only Yahweh, the true God, can help them in their time of need.
因底下咧宣告只有耶和华上帝才是因的上帝，才有法通帮助因。
Therefore, the psalmist is saying, "My help comes not from the false God, but from the true God."
所以诗人一直讲，我的帮助唔是对怀假神，是对耶和华上帝来的。
My help comes from the Lord and not from anyone else.
我的帮助是对上帝耶和华来，唔是对任何一个人来的。
In our own situation right now, what need do we help?
所以在咱的目前的情形呢？ 咱若需要帮助，咱的帮助是对倒落来的呢？
And as we seek help, who do we go to?
所以当咱需要帮助的时阵，咱去找谁啊讨帮助呢？
It's natural for us to go to our family.
真自然，咱若遇到问题的时阵，咱哦头一个就是走去找咱厝内的人。
We run to our friends or even our church.
啊是去找咱的朋友，啊是找教会。
Or maybe our small group or some of our relatives.
啊是咱的一些亲戚，啊是教会的小组。
Yes, this is good.
是啊，这是对的。
But we need to realize, we can ask for help for someone who is better.
但是，咱都爱怎样讲说，咱发当搁找另外一位比咱跩朋友、亲人，互咱搁较好的帮助。
Some of us may be tempted. If we are sick, we are tempted to go to the best doctor.
有时阵当一个人在破病的时阵，因哦就是爱去找医生，去给医生看脉。
Whether in the Philippines or outside.
无论是伫菲律宾，还是去外国。
Yes, this is good.
是，这个是对，这个是好事。
But there is someone who is more able to do it.
但是我要让你知影，也够另外一位比医生更加牛的。
There is someone who is more able to help us.
这个有一位比医生更加能帮助你的。
And that is our Lord.
伊就是咱的主，咱的上帝。
And the psalmist gives us two reasons why is it best for us to turn to God for help.
诗篇121篇的给我们为什么耶和华上帝是我们最好的帮助。
The first is the Lord is able.
头一个是让我们知道说我们的上帝他是有能力的。
The Lord is available.
第二个是让我们知道我们的上帝是每时每刻都有法能帮助我们的。
The Lord is able.
头一个是说我们的上帝他是有能力有法能帮助我们的。
My help comes from the Lord who is maker of heaven and earth.
我的帮助是对造天对耶和华来的。
In Genesis chapter 1 it says God created the heavens and the earth.
在创世纪第一章，让咱知影讲说，上帝伊伫啊创造天地。
And he created it by just the power of his word.
就是对伊讲话的能力，就发通做天地。
Indeed, God is a great God.
咱的上帝是一个伟大的上帝。
And he has a very impressive resume.
而且你咱也知影，咱的上帝有一个予人印象深刻的叫做能力。
And he created everything.
因为伊是创造万民的主。
Reflect with me. Think about how big is our God?
咱来好好思想，到底咱的上帝到底是何等的伟大呢？
Did you know that there are other worlds out there that we haven't still explored?
你敢知影，还佫有除了咱自己世界外口，外面还佫有另外一挂世界，咱还佫毋捌去看到，还是去探索到？
There are so many places under the sea that we haven't explored yet.
譬如讲，伫海洋内面，伫深海内面，下骹诶海洋内面，有真侪物件，咱人还佫无法通。
Outside our solar system and our galaxy is so vast and it's limitless. And there are many creations that we have yet to see. And if God created the heavens and the earth, is there anything that he cannot do?
所以当咱的上帝若创造天甲地，有兼别项代志，伊无法通做到的吗？
For us, when we face problems and difficulties,
所以当咱面对着问题困难的时阵，
we are invited to go to the best help that we can get.
伊只邀请咱去到找一位法能真正法能帮，将最地好的帮助赐予咱。
Let us go to the Lord.
咱来去找咱的上帝。
Because He alone is able.
因为伊才有法通帮助咱。
He is bigger than any of our problems.
因为伊比咱所有的问题更加大。
And God is able to help us climb our mountains.
而且上帝会帮助咱，让咱有力量来行面对咱的山。
What else can we learn?
然后咱可能学习到什么呢？
The second is God is available.
第二是讲到咱的上帝，伊是特时特刻有法通帮助咱。
How then God makes Himself available to us?
到底上帝要怎样让伊特时特刻通帮助咱呢？
The psalmist gives us three things.
诗篇给咱有三项物件。
The Lord's care is constant.
上帝伊会照顾，伊看好是无变的。
The Lord's care is close.
上帝伊会照顾，伊关怀呢是真近咱。
And the Lord's care is continuing.
然后上帝伊看顾呢是继续的无停。
God's care is constant.
上帝伊会看顾照顾是无改变的无变的。
He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep.
伊的确无叫你的脚摇动，保护你的也确袂独眠，保护以色列的也袂独眠，也袂爱困。
In other words, God's care is 24/7.
换句话来讲，上帝伊对咱的看顾照顾呢是一日24小时，一礼拜7日。
God's care is throughout the day and night.
上帝伊照顾看顾是。 无对日时到暗暝，再个日时到暗暝是安尼继续的。
Let me ask you for us here who are in business or even our place of work.
请问咱中间，咱想要有家己有开生意的，还是有工作的？
How many security guards do you have?
你伫你的公司内面，你有请多少保安人员呢？
How many shifts do they work?
伊每一日应该都爱做几棚的工作呢？
For most of us, we hire maybe at least two security guards.
对真侪人来讲，有可能伫伊个公司内面，伫伊个生意内面，伊所请个保安人员哦，真少有两位。
One will guard us during the evening, and one will guard us throughout the morning.
就是两位内面，有诶是12小时，一个是过早起，一个是过暗时诶。
But unfortunately, even though we hire security guards, they still fail.
但是 真可惜，虽然咱请真侪保安人员的时阵，有时阵咱也是有一寡代志袂安生会发生的。
And there are times that they even sleep on the job.
有时阵咱会抓着咱在咧高经的在保安人员吼底下咧爱困。
Why？
为虾米呢
？Because they are limited.
因为因受了限制。
They are only human.
因只不过是人
，they get tired，
因的亚仙
，their strength is limited，
因的力量呢，因的气力是有限制。
But the God of the Bible says He is not a God who slumbers。
但是圣经和咱正阿讲，咱的上帝伊是袂独眠的。
To slumber means to get drowsy。
啊，独眠就是意思讲说，就是伫要爱困咯。
In Tagalog, hindi antokin si Lord。
和咱正阿讲说，伫菲律宾话讲说，咱的上帝是袂独眠的。
How about the mothers who are among us？Can you remember the time that you, when you are feeding your baby?
你也过我通回想到你迄时阵，你个囡仔生出来时阵，你咧养饲你个这个囡仔。
In the middle of the night, you try to feed your baby because they're crying so loud.
就是伫半暝个时阵呢，当你囡仔伫遐大声咧嚎咧叫个时阵，你就对你个困眠起来，然后就要饲伊食。
And even though you're so sleepy, you carry your child and feed him or her.
虽然你也真，你非常的爱困呢，但是你也是要起来，底下要饲这个囡仔食。
So that the baby will be pacified.
所以这个婴仔在底下袂够好咯。
But because of your tiredness, you fell asleep.
但是你因为伤过爱困，伤过闲，你忽然间在底下困去。
And then you suddenly wake up.
然后你忽然间在醒起来。
Feeling that guilt.
你感觉你家己真自责。
You could have dropped your child while you were sleeping.
你希望讲说，当你咧爱困时阵，你也阁将你这个婴仔还在抱条条。
Despite your love, you are still limited.
虽然你真疼你的婴仔，你疼你的囡仔，但是你的疼也阁是受限制。
But God's love is more than the love of mothers.
但是咱知影上帝对咱的疼是比老母疼囡仔的疼阁较大。
God loves us so much.
上帝非常的疼咱。
And when we cry out to Him,
当咱对伊底下来呼求呼叫的时阵
，He will carry us in His arms.
伊就将咱底下用伊手甲咱抱起来。
And this is His promise.
这就是伊对咱的应允。
That He will not sleep nor slumber.
伊袂独眠也袂爱困。
Because He is a God who can watch over us.
因为伊是上帝底下通来看顾咱照顾咱。
That's the love of God.
这就是互人看到上帝对咱的疼。
The Lord's care is also close.
第二项可能看到上帝对咱的关怀、的照顾呢，是真近的。
The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night.
保护你的是耶和华，耶和华在你的正边荫庇你。白日日头就较袂伤你，夜间月亮就较袂害你。
In the mid-90s, Bette Midler.Had a song.
The 1990s 时阵，有一位歌星，伊底下有录一段歌。
This was a quite famous song.
这首好像讲说是出名的诗歌。
So sing with me.
咱来三合唱。
And God is watching us. God is watching us. God is watching us
from a distance.
It's a famous song back then.
这个是当时1990年代的一首真出名的歌。
Actually, this was our graduation song when I graduated in elementary.
我记因为跟那这首歌对我真深的印象呢，是当我咧毕业小学时阵吼，伫毕业典礼吼，阮唱这歌啦。
The song says, "God is watching us from a distance."
这首歌甲咱讲说，上帝伫远远的所在底下咧看咱，伫远远的所在咧看咱。
很简单，三种song。The song is very beautiful.
我认为这首歌吼，实是真水。
But somehow the song is in a way incorrect.
但是我是认为讲说，这首歌内面的歌词哦，可能有唔对啊，无合适。
Or it's also incomplete.
啊，是讲说这首歌的歌词内面哦，无完全。
Yes, God is the God who can watch us from a distance.
是啊，咱的上帝，我当伫远远的所在底下咧看咱每一个。
But not only that.
但是就无单单远远的。
God is a God who can watch His people and His children up close.
上帝，当时啊，我当伫真近呢，所真近哦，看伊个人，看伊个行伫。
God can watch us very near.
上帝，我当伫真近的底下来看过人。
The Lord is your shade at your right hand.
上帝就是伫咱正边，伊是咱正手边，会咱来荫庇咱。
God's shade is our protection.
上帝恩庇就是咱的保护。
God's love is our shield.
上帝的疼就是咱的盾牌。
And there's this one proverb that says, God is nearer than our own shadow.
然后有一个叫做安尼话，安尼讲呢，讲说一个俗言，安尼讲说，上帝吼，伊的军比交咱的军度一个深度，是比咱的人的咱的家己的影搁较近啊。
How can our shadow be near?
到底咱人咱的影要怎啊伫遐交咱搁较近呢
？What does it do with us?
到底伊交咱有啥物关系呢？咱创啥呢
？Whether we like it or not, our shadow will follow us wherever we go.
无论你愿意还是无愿意，你要啊无要，咱的影拢随时会跟着咱。
But the God whom we worship is closer than that.
但是咱所敬拜的上帝是比咱家己影搁较近咱。
Unfortunately, there will be times that when we face trials.
但是有时阵呢，当咱面对着试炼的时阵。
We will feel that God is so cold and so far.
咱会感觉到上帝对咱真冷漠，还是伫遐远远的离开咱。
And we ask the question, "Where is the Lord?"
然后就问咱家己，我拄着问题，上帝伫倒落呢
？Why has God abandoned us?
为什么上帝那放弃我
？Why has God forgotten us?
为什么上帝那未记我咯
？But from this question, God has given us His answer.
但是对这个问题，上帝给咱伊的答案。
That I will be the shade at your right hand.
我就是伫你遮手边，遮手边底下来荫庇你。
I will be near。
我就是真近，我近你，真近你。
Our God is near。
咱的上帝是真近，咱每一位。
And there's another thing that we can learn。
然后第三项，咱常学习呗。
The Lord's care is continuing。
上帝对咱的关怀，会看顾呢是继续，是无停的。
The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life.The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore.
耶和华要保护你，免受一切的灾害。伊要保护你的生命，日出日入。耶和华要保护你，对今时直到永远。
God's love and God's help is limitless.
咱知影上帝的疼甲上帝的帮助哦，是无受限制。
However, whenever we face problems, we go to a different way.
但是真可惜，当咱拄到问题时，阵咱行另外一条路。
We rely on other people.
咱底下挖苦别人。
We rely on our own resource.
咱挖苦咱家己所有发的开力。
Na experience niyo bang ma-max out yung credit card niyo?
你捌经历到恁咧用一张信用卡的时阵，用了超过你个超过个数目咯
？I experienced that.
我捌经历到。
And it's very painful.
然后对我真讲是真痛苦的。
In the time of your need, you cannot go forward.
就是当你真最底需要要用钱的时阵，一张信用卡无法通来互你用到。
Some of us rely on our health insurances.
有一挂人因是伫遐外靠因的健康的保险。
Or perhaps feel health discounts.
啊是要伫遐来看人 feel health 一挂叫做靠这当帮助你。
Well, these are good. God is inviting us for so much more.
虽然做是无唔对，但是上帝邀请人搁较底下通来找搁较大的帮助。
God is telling us that His help is limitless.
上帝甲咱讲说，伊予咱的帮助是无受限制。
With God, there is no end for His help.
对上帝来讲，伊的帮助是永远无停的继续的。
Our parents may help us.
咱的父母发能帮助咱。
Our friends may help us.
咱的朋友发能帮助咱。
Our relatives may help us.
咱的亲人发能帮助咱。
But only up to a certain extent.
但是因跩所谓帮助是只有到一个限度。
But God the Lord, He is there, ready to help us anytime.
但是咱的上帝是任何时阵底下拢发通帮助咱。
And His help is limitless.
但伊予咱的帮助呢，也是受无受了限制。
And therefore, God calls us.
然后呢，上帝就底下来呼叫咱。
Call on the Lord because He is our keeper, who is able and available to us.
咱应该就底下来呼叫咱的上帝，因为伊是有法有能力，甲达时达刻。
Let us call on the Lord because He is our keeper.
咱应该都求告呼叫咱的上帝，因是咱的守护者。
God is able and God is available.
因为上帝是有能力的，上帝是达时达刻我能帮助咱的。
Let's look again at this psalm and see what we can notice here.
咱过一摆来看这个诗篇121篇，咱就会发现到有一挂什么所在。
He who watches over you will not slumber.He who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord will keep you from all harm. The Lord will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going. Let me ask you, what is the repeated word?
请问哦, 在这个诗篇里面,有一个字,重复是什么字呢?
It's watch.
是保护.
In other translation, it's keep.
在别的话,也是说自己保守.
In the original language, they share the same word, watch and keep. What does it mean?
在原文里面,意思是说,就是保护还是保守,到底这个是什么意思呢?
To watch or to keep means to guard, to defend, or to protect.
意思是说,守卫,还是保卫,还是保护.
In the Chinese translation, it says, 保护.
就是在韩文,会说是保护.
It means to protect, to cover, to defend, to preserve or safeguard.
是说是给你保护,给你加看,给你加杂.
So what is the theme of this psalm?
到底这个诗篇里面,它的主题是在说什么呢?
The Lord is our keeper.
我们的上帝是我们的守护者.
The Lord is our keeper.
我们的上帝是在那里保守我们,要看顾我们.
Can you say that with me? The Lord is our keeper.
那我们三个说, the Lord is our keeper.
1, 2, 3. The Lord is our keeper. Can you say to the person beside you, the Lord is our keeper?
你可能跟你边头的人说, the Lord is our keeper.
The Lord is your keeper.
The Lord is your keeper.
In other words, God is our bodyguard.
换句话来说, 上帝是我们的保镖.
The Lord is our bodyguard.
上帝是我们的保镖.
If you have a bodyguard like this, would you feel safe?
假设你若像美国总统一边头的这位保镖, 你有感觉到安全吗?
Would you feel secure?
你感觉有安全感吗?
Of course, I would feel safe.
对我来说,当然我感觉我很安全啊。
But unfortunately, these guards, they also have limits.
但是对这位保镖来说,他们是有限制。
They get tired.
他们是压线。
Some of them may be sleeping on the job also.
有时候,他们工作时会肚子爱睡。
They have limit in their strength.
他们的能力是有限制。
But God is calling us to something better. God is inviting us to the best help that we can get. And that is to go to Him. And therefore, we need to call on the Lord because He is our keeper who is able and available.
So we need to call on the Lord because He is able and available. So we need to call on the Lord because He is.
And you may ask, what kind of help can God give us?
你就问这条问题,到底上帝给我们的帮助是什么样的帮助呢?
How can the Lord help me?
到底上帝要怎么帮助我呢?
The psalmist says, He will not let your foot slip.
诗篇跟我们说,上帝不会让你的脚摇动.
The sun will not harm you by day.
白日,日头的脚不会伤你.
It will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night.
还是在迷失.
The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life.
上帝要免受你一切灾害，要保护你的性命。
Now then, does this verses mean that we will have a problem-free life?
那对这经文来看的时阵，是不是我们按你讲说，咱的人生就无问题了吗？
Does this verses mean that we will no longer face difficulties?
这经节是不是跟咱讲说，咱就袂去拄着困难吗？
Of course not. Because if we no longer face problems or difficulties, we wouldn't need the help of God. We wouldn't ask the Lord to help us. So what do these verses mean? It means that even in the midst of our trials and difficulties, as we climb our own mountains, as we overcome the challenges in our lives, God's help is near. God's help is available. Because He is able. And when the Bible talks about help, it means one thing. It is not a help of an assistant. It is not a help from a household helper. But the help is a help of rescue. A rescue from life and death. A rescue from death. That is the protection. That is the help that God offers us.
这就是上帝给我们的帮助。
And so this morning, I'd like to invite a brother who would share his experience about the Lord, how God has been a helper and a keeper of his life. Brothers and sisters, let us please welcome Stephen C.
兄弟姐妹们，邀请Stephen兄弟。
Thank you, Pastor Jen and Brother Peter. You know, there are a few things that you could ask me to do here in front, but one of them is, but if you ask me to tell my testimony, to be honest, I would hesitate before because I just felt that I never had a good story to tell. Well, I guess God is gracious and He had other plans. Anyway, on the morning of February 27 this year, after a few, I was working late nights during that time. I woke up early that day to bring my daughter to school. And I suddenly noticed that my head was hurting pretty bad. It was hurting so bad to the point that it got worse and I started vomiting. And I was so weak that I couldn't even get up to eat, to just have a normal day in at home. And this headache, it persisted for 1 week. You know? And my brother-in-law, he's a radiologist, he said, you know, your headache's been 1 week already, why don't you go have a CT scan just to have it checked out, just to rule out anything. Well, unfortunately, the CT scan showed that I had a tumor in my pituitary gland. Now the pituitary gland is the gland that it's at the base of your skull. If you draw a line here straight to the base of your skull, that's where it is. And what it does is it regulates all your body's hormones. It's like the control tower of all the hormones of your body. And so the tumor was on the gland and it was limiting the functions of the gland. Due to that, I had to get an MRI and lab test, blood test. So we got it, and during that course, we showed it to two doctors, and both of them said that due to the results, especially because of they were pointing to my sodium levels. My sodium levels were dangerously low, and I had to be hospitalized. And of course, that reaction freaked us out, me and my wife out, because, you know, why hospitalization? My brother-in-law also asked his fellow doctors, and they told him that most likely I was to be operated on, so it was even more despairing news, you know, because why operation? But it was, in hindsight, as I look back, it was good because at least God gave us a lot of opinions that all pointed to the same thing, that I had to be operated on. And little did I know, but God knew, that I didn't have so much time in my hands. When we got the MRI, we had to set the doctor's appointments, but it took so long, so my brother-in-law just said, you know, pack your bags and go straight to the emergency room so that you can be taken care of right away because you might not have that much time. So when we got to the emergency room, the doctors saw my results and they said, you know what, we have to confine you to the ICU. The reason for that is your sodium levels are so low that you're 1 point before getting comatose. At first they were saying you go to sleep, but they were saying that I would, if it got 1 point lower, I would be comatose already. And also, what happened was the MRI showed that the tumor had bled, had hemorrhaged, and that was the reason why I started getting the headaches, why I had vomiting and all that. And they said that the tumor could possibly bleed again. So that would make my condition even worse. And worse is that the tumor was actually touching on my optic nerve. During that time, actually, my eyesight was so bad, I couldn't even read my cell phone, I couldn't read my laptop. And they said if it grew any bigger, it might sever my optic nerve and render me totally blind. So I didn't have a lot of time, so I had to be admitted even to the ICU. It was, we went to the hospital at around middle of the afternoon. I got into the ICU at around 3 a.m. And, you know, it was really, the whole process was really depressing. And, it would be normal for everybody, anyone, just to start worrying. But, you know what, God was, from that time on, I could sense that God was working because he kept reassuring me. In fact, one verse that kept sticking to me was what he was actually doing behind the scene. I remember this verse, "We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us through wordless groans, because the Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance with the will of God." So during that time that I was in the ICU, God was actually giving me peace, a peace that transcends all understanding. To the point that, like, even with the nurses, when the nurses would minister to me, I had enough peace to even be, you know, God was telling me to be a salt and light to them. Because, you know, if you ever been in the ICU, and most patients don't realize what goes on with them in the ICU, the nurses do short of miraculous stuff to the patients in the ICU, and they really need a lot of encouragement. So God was telling me, be a salt and light to these nurses. Another person that, of course, I had to reassure was my wife, my wife Hailin, no? Because, of course, because of my condition, you know, there was a lot of stress and worrying about, of course, I could not make it through, or you know, I could be blind after that. But, you know, God was reassuring me to the point that I could reassure her that, hey, God is assuring me that he's going to take us through this. March 15, that was a Sunday, that was the day of my operation. And that night, I really couldn't sleep. Partly thanks to this life support system monitor that was taking my blood pressure every 30 minutes. So it kept waking me up every 30 minutes. But of course, this is my first ever operation that I had. So I was very worried and very anxious the night. But, you know, God just kept me through. In fact, the morning as they were prepping me up for the operation, instead of feeling, defeated or helpless, I actually felt like a soldier going out to battle, or maybe, you know, some great adventure, you know, just before a great adventure when you know that God is leading you through that adventure. It was, of course, comforting when my wife, my parents, and my godparents also came to visit prior to being wheeled in. But, you know, God was working even during before I went into the operating room. You know, when the time came that I had to be operated on, they wheeled me in. They put the anesthesia, you know, mask on me, and I just fell asleep. I woke up a few hours after, and you know what? The feeling I had was amazing. It felt like I just came from a deep sea dive, you know, like I came out of the water, and you know, you're taking out your gear and you're telling people how good the dive was. You know, it was like an amazing dive. That's the closest feeling that I can describe. And it was like a dive wherein God held you by the hand and took you around, and it was amazing because you knew that God was holding you by the hand. And one thing that I remember that God did was he put this unexplainable burden to me just to share the gospel. In fact, one of the first things that we did, I was telling my wife, text the people that I know who didn't know Christ. Tell them that they need Christ. I had just had this burden to share that God was real, that God is there in the time of need. And during my recovery, you know, God was still there. I couldn't, right after the operation, I couldn't breathe straight through my nose because it was bandaged. Oh, by the way, that's how they got my tumor out. Instead of the usual, you know, taking the whole thing out, taking the whole head out, they went through my nose. One interesting piece is that when we asked the doctor, you know, he said, you know, everything about the operation was unremarkable, which is actually good because it means there's no complication that happened. And it's so unremarkable, and everything though was ideal. And they said, even the shape of your nose is ideal for the operation. And I remember the verse, I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. You know, God, even the way he creates us is wonderful. And even as I recovered, I spent 3 more days in the ICU. And then after that, they moved me to a regular room. And within that one day, I was able to stand up and I started walking around already. And then as soon as they got me walking, the next day they just discharged me already. So everybody was saying, hey man, that was a very fast recuperation. And to add to that, the doctor said, you know what, your prognosis is pretty good because 50 to 75% of the patients who undergo that procedure, you know, they lose a lot of the hormonal functions. That means that they'll be dependent on, you know, hormonal injections for the rest of their life. For me, you know, I don't have to go through that. Yeah, praise God, I don't have that intense maintenance to do. And God is great. God is to be praised. Yeah, and I remember that first morning in that, because in the ICU, it's all walls, there's no windows. That first morning in the regular room, and you saw the sunrise, it was just, you know, it just was just so beautiful. And I don't like to cry. I'm not a person who hates crying, actually. But I had a little, you know, MP3 player playing, and I was playing every time it would play a worship song, I would just be crying in tears, you know, and then I was just like an awakening, and I praise God for that. And this experience has taught me a few things, and first thing is that God is really constantly looking out for me. And if you trace back the events, you could see that God's hand was in every point, at every time in the events. And also, whenever God puts us to trying times like this, what the attitude perhaps that we should get is, we should ask God, why is it that he had put us here? Why did he allow us to undergo this? Not in a negative way, but rather you should ask God, what is your message for me so that I could use it for your glory? And, you know, this thing has made me appreciate the verse, and we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. It makes me appreciate that verse more clearly. Thank you for your prayers. I know it was this service that Sunday when they made the announcement that the operation was successful. And I thank you for your prayers and support. Well, you know, right now this is my story. This is my song. And I'm praising my Savior all the day long. Thank you.
Praise God. So Peter will be sharing a few points to translate some of the testimony of our brother.
Well, like Kantan, like Juan Giac, Stephen Hiati, Yekenjang, Hinley Hiati, Tikini, Taputo, Dige, a Kamkak, Tikitaki Kunsi, Zuni, Taukak Zin Tian, then now it's called a Tiasi, Zungang, Batso, Tutio. So it's way out the yard to keep Tay Yi Sunny. So what ten to the Ye Tao Lo, a Loy Libin, Ye Kyotwe, Sweet Swan. It's a sweet swan, see, let Kong Zelan Lang, let Hun Kong Zet, Hooding Bong, a Hun B, it's a key guan. Then it quite the Ye Saw Zai need to take a Jim Liu, Jiab Liu, the Akai Kai 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 Tetley. So it's a whole idea, Tao de Tiani. The Chani. 因为有一个瘤伫一个脑的内面呢，影响到伊目睭，伊看到，因为伊将伊这个脑到目睭这条神经线给断了。但是呢，咱的兄弟伊虽然拄到这款的病痛呢，伫这几个过程中，对找医生到伊有通一个真成功的手术呢，伊第二个人见证是上帝，每一步拢亲手伫遐来带领伊，无论是医生、 在医生在专家底下来帮助，啊是要给安排叫做伫泰国房，啊是无论是去到 ICU， 无论在手术一切方面呢，到伊底下复原的时阵呢，真紧的复原，无需要公司独个再独个去签药底下通来予伊的这个胡林邦分泌正常，所以达项拢是上帝诶带领诶看好。所以伊予咱知影公司伫伊所经过着即款诶病痛中，伊予咱知影公司上帝伫遐有予伊学习着一寡功课。伊就是公司当咱每一个人拄着无论是伫病痛还是伫试炼中诶时阵，咱应该着来问上帝，到底上帝你伫我问题伫病痛中，到底你诶旨意，你要予我学习什么？你的旨意是什么呢？然后呢，第二是讲到咱对问题、对艰苦、对病痛，咱应该有的态度，咱应该有看什么款的态度？咱的态度是应该，无论是伫病痛中、伫问题当中的时阵呢，咱有关底下将一切荣耀归乎咱的上帝。所以伊就是用罗马书第八章二十八节来结论，和咱只讲说啊，上帝真听咱每一位，伊是叫好叫万事互相效力，叫听上帝的人得到益处，所以也是在一个所在，也是咱教会兄弟姊妹，在伊在拄着病痛中的时阵，咱的关怀，咱替伊祈祷，也来咱每一位讲万二分的多谢。
We praise the Lord for the life of our brother。
咱为着咱兄弟伊的人生伊的经历，也来献上感恩。
Why don't we clap our hands again to our God for His goodness？
咱搁一摆来拍手来阿罗咱的上帝。
In our time of help, let us call on the Lord.
在咱需要帮助的时阵，咱就要来求告咱的上帝。
Let us call on Him because our God is our keeper.
咱就求告咱的上帝，因为上帝是咱的守护者。
And He is our watcher who is able and available to us.
因为伊是伫遐，逐时逐刻伫遐有能力，逐时逐刻将大家看顾咱。
And as we come to a close, I would like to share a few more things.
所以等咱要来结束咱今仔日的篇道理的时阵，咱来搁来思想一寡物件。
Now that we know that the Lord is our keeper, what then should we do?
所以当现在咱已经知影，讲说上帝是咱的守护者，咱应该着创啥呢
？I hope you'll reflect and consider these things.
咱来好好思想、默想这几项。
First, let our hearts be filled with peace.
和咱的心来充满了平安。
Whatever you're going through right now, you don't have to be afraid.
所以无论你现在所经过着是啥物，你无需要惊吓。
Because the Lord is watching you up close.
因为上帝真近的所在，伫阿咧看好你。
I remember last month, I'm sure you've heard about this. My father-in-law had a surgery.
我相信你伫经过个，你有听到我的丈人伫阿有需要经过开刀。
Part of his colon was blocked by a tumor.
因为伊我的丈人的大肠吼，有一所在刚好是好一粒。
And he had difficulty in bowel movement, and it had blood.
So, every time he had to go to the toilet, he had very difficult. And then, when he was going to the toilet, he saw blood.
Actually, it was already 1 year, but the checkup was delayed and delayed.
虽然这项代志是一年前已经发现着，但是伊我的丈人伫遐眼前无随时去找医生。
And then when the doctor found out, we were advised that it has to be removed immediately.
所以当阮最后找医生的时阵，医生就甲阮讲说，应该着将迄个所在底下给腾起来。
To make the long story short, God led us to the right doctors at the right time at the right moment.
换一句话来讲，上帝带领阮，互阮去找对的医生。
And when we were in the hospital after the operation, it was very successful. We were talking to each other.
所以当我的丈人伊伫遐有完成这个真成功的手术呢，伊醒的时阵，阮就三个伫遐咧沟通。
And we were reflecting in a way the perfect timing and the coordination of events.
所以阮就咧默想咧思想讲说，跩代志每一个过程伊发生的过程呢，逐项拢是真摆啊真好势。
But my father-in-law wasn't able to speak, but he called our attention.
虽然我的丈人迄时阵呢，伊也无法通来讲话，但是伊叫阮大家人来。
And all he did was this.
然后伊所做的是整头我举顶面。
He reminded us that it is God who has worked in his life, and not the doctors, not even us.
伊就伫遐，我的丈人就互阮知影讲说，唔是医生的搞，而是阮法通创啥，乃是上帝。底下来帮助你，可以好起来。
And I would like to extend our thanks and gratitude to RCBCP family.
当时我是借着这个机会，恩咱主来兄弟姊妹，咱的大家庭来讲我万二分的多谢。
Thank you so much for your support.
多谢恁每一个人的支持。
Thank you so much for your prayers and encouragement.
多谢恁的鼓励，恁的祈祷。
Thank you so much for your love and care to us.
多谢恁对阮这家庭的疼甲关怀。
And today, our family is here. My father-in-law is there. Papa, can you stand up?
今仔日我会叫人伫咱中间。
So we thank the Lord for His faithfulness in our family. The God whom we experience is the same God whom Stephen experienced. But He is also the same God whom all of us can experience. If we just call on His name, if we just put our faith in Him, may our hearts be filled with peace and not fear. As you make decisions, what drives your decision? Is it fear? Is it worry? You want to enroll your children to a lot of summer classes? Fearing that they may miss out? While the desire for us is to give the best to our children, we should be driven by peace and not fear. Because only God can hold the future. Are you thinking about the future? A future family? Or your business? Or provision for your old age? Do not be afraid. Because God is with you. When you work 6 days a week, and then you find yourself resting on the seventh day, are you enjoying it? At this very moment, are you thinking about your work tomorrow? Are you thinking about that business deal that you have to close this week? Are you thinking about that scheduled checkup that you need to set for the doctor? I pray that you will experience that rest that God is offering. Because God is watching you. God is near. And second, let us put our trust in the Lord. Have you experienced difficulty lately? Did you experience any accident? Remember, it could have been worse. Things could have been worse if God did not intervene. I remember I was playing when I was young. And because of my excitement, I jumped back and fell on a glass table. Praise God, I was saved. I only had a small wound, smaller than a 25
centavo
coin. We just walked to the doctor. And I was telling myself, honestly, I was telling this to myself. I was grade school then. Ano bang klaseng buhay ito? But because that time I did not know about God that much. But as I come to know the Lord, I came to realize
亲近上帝、认捌上帝的时阵，我就发现着这项代志。
That God has been watching me since I was young。
就是当我细汉的时阵，我也阁未认捌伊的时阵，上帝就已经在看好我了。
And that is the God who watches us。
这就是咱的上帝在看顾咱每一位。
I believe God helps us and even intervenes for us more than we can imagine。
我相信上帝在遐啊，帮助咱超过咱所想到的，在遐来干涉咱一寡代志。
Who knows?You have been saved from a car accident, from a more fatal car accident.
无论你想想到有，若是上帝会看顾上帝干涉你时阵，有可能咱所拄到意外是非常的严重，至到生命危险。
Or an injury that surprised you.
啊，是对咱的一款受伤严重性的受伤。
Or the trial or the delays in your goals.
啊，是公司所拄到的一啊跩试炼、跩困难。
Remember, it could have been worse.
又想讲，那不是上帝听你看过，有可能跩更加严重、更加凄惨。
Another thing is, we need to trust in the Lord because we are in good hands.
对，互咱各行在公司，咱应该就信靠咱的上帝，因为咱伫上帝手诶是第好诶。
Can you say that to your seatmate? Trust in God because you are in good hands.
陈焕刚，你边啊头人讲无
？Trust in God because you are in good hands.
Trust in God because you are in good hands.
You are in good hands because God is able and available.
你伫上帝手诶，底下是做第好诶，因为上帝有法通能力来保护你，也达是达克通帮助你。
As our brother said to us,
当咱兄弟甲咱分享
，Let's ask God.
咱底下求告上帝。
Lord, why do you allow this to me?
你为虾米好这样代志临到我诶身顶
？Why do you allow this?
你为虾米好这样代志出现
？Yes, it's okay to ask for a complaint.
是会，咱会做问上帝跩问题。
But let us ask something beyond that.
但是咱所问问题应该都爱超过跩为什么？为什么
？Let us ask something. God, why? What do you want me to learn about my situation?
咱应该就当咱拄到跩问题困难变天，咱讲说上帝啊，伫跩代志顶面，你要让我学习着什么功课
？Who do you want me to encourage with my experience?
你爱我遮着我所拄到的经历，要鼓励上安尼。
I pray that for us, brothers and sisters, we will assume.That God has the best interest for all of us.
兄弟姊妹，我要让咱知影，讲说上帝对咱每一个人的意念是第好的。
Especially in the midst of our trials.
就是当咱在试炼中。
Do not believe that God has abandoned you.
唔通啊，去何忙去骗去哦？讲到上帝已经是无要插你、帮你咯。
As you go out in this place.
当你离开这个所在。
As you start to think of work.Starting tomorrow,
当你开始思想你明仔日的工作
，I should face your mountains and starting your journey once more this week.
当你面对你的大山，然后你开始搁要行一条山的路呢
？I pray that you will trust the Lord.
我底下祈祷，你可能底下来信靠咱的上帝
，and let His presence, His wisdom, His love guide you.
好，用阮伊的同在、伊的智慧、伊的关怀底下来指导你、指示你。
May we call on the Lord.Who is our keeper because he is able and available.
但我们大家发人底下来呼求呼叫咱的上帝耶和华，因为伊是底下发是咱的受苦者，有法通来有能力帮助咱，达时达刻帮助咱。
And for the last time, can we read this together? 1, 2, 3. Call on the Lord. He is our keeper who is able and available.